class here at Altea Active. All right, we're going to begin by lying down on our backs. So just relax on your backs here. Allow your feet to splay apart. Let your arms move away from your body. Close your eyes. Allow the chin to be lower than the forehead. We're just going to take these first few moments to settle in here, to let go, to be mindful, and just enjoy this moment. Even though we're in a 30-minute Yin Yoga class, we're going to still get the amazing, beautiful benefits of this practice. Just holding poses a little less, but still just as incredibly tense, and then therefore calming. So we'll begin by just checking with our breath. Just notice your natural inhalation, your natural exhalation. Just breathing in and breathing out. Follow the breath from the very beginning of the inhale to the very end of the inhale, and follow the breath to the very beginning of the exhale to the very end of the exhale. Just feeling your day drop away, letting go of all the external noise, letting go of everything outside the space, and allowing yourself breath. wrapping these legs, and then you're going to tip all the way to your left. And as you tip to the left, option if you wanted to put a cushion under your knee, eye gaze can go up to the ceiling or maybe over towards your right arm, just adding a little more twist through that right side of the body, maybe to the spine. And then once again, find your breath. Visualize breathing from the your glutes, your waistline, all the way up the side body, rib cage, into the armpit, collarbone swell, exhale, let go. Close the eyes, just enjoy some stillness. exhale, slowly take the legs up towards the center. Unravel those legs here. Let the legs bend, remain bent for this moment. Let's take the arms in cactus. So arms out shoulder height, bend the elbows, fingers face the back wall. Let's roll all the way to the right. And then press yourself up to seated, coming facing forward. We're gonna move into long-legged butterfly pose. So here in butterfly, let's take the soles of the feet together. Knees fall out comfortably. We want to make sure that the legs are a long-legged butterfly, so they're a little farther apart. So not really close into here. Take the feet out further. Relaxing the legs. Now I like to also just grab sitting flush from the front to the back. Use little kickstands, these are called here. As we're going to be leaning up over and forward, once again, options to support the legs, maybe having cushions in the front as we move into this pose slowly. Let's take a nice long inhale, reach up, and exhale, just let the body float to where it naturally stops. Relax the head down, chin to chest, relax the back of the neck, and in the end, we just come to that very beginning place. That's called our edge, the place where we just begin to feel bit of resistance in our body, not having to move really far past it, not having to jam past that place, just allow yourself to be there. We call it Goldilocks, not too much, not too little, just right. Just find the edge, and once again, relax the body, connect to that cycle of breath. Exhale slowly. Visualize the breath starting at the tip of the tailbone, moving all the way out the crown of the head. Exhale. Now over time you might notice that the head starts to move down a little farther, maybe the arms come out a little further forward. That just moves into our next edge, and then we move through the same principles of yin. Finding your edge. Still in time. Now wherever you feel that tension, that resistance, that little feeling in your body, that's exactly where this pose is working on you. The pose here, we work on the body from the inside out. Slowly begin to walk the hands back and up, all the way up. Stretch the legs out for a moment here. Give the feet a little circle at the ankles. Maybe pop the chest up a bit. That was a lot of forward bending we were doing. Just take your time and move it side to side. Passive back opener. So in Sphinx, we come down all the way onto the ground. toenails, relax the feet. And in this sense here, we're already in just a natural back bend. From here, moving into space pose, releasing the buttocks. Come all the way up, catch hold of opposite elbows. Elbows are directly underneath the shoulders. Take the hands forward, interlace the fingers or palms on the ground. And you can let the head just release down if you want, maybe taking the chin side to side. Or for some people, they just enjoy the head up for a moment or two. Maybe getting deeper into the compression that we are putting into our spine. Once again, let go of the buttocks and feel the face of the pelvis melting. So back bends are known as our natural energizers. They give us energy. Also let us sleep at night. Visualize the breath starting from the tip of the tailbone, rising up out of the crown of the head. And as you exhale, completely feel yourself sinking and melting into the mat. So in back bends, as we compress the vertebrae, are the bones of the back. We are essentially building up the strength inside your vertebrae. This is such a wonderful healing pose. It is a great antidote for a lot of sitting. So prolonged sitting, such as driving a car, working on a computer, texting, you know, even watching TV. So that might be a lot of what's happening now as we stay at home. So here, back bends, I'm going to say this is like number one pose to do. I'm going to give the option for those who just like to add a little further back bend, but if you're feeling quite nice in this pose right now, you feel like your back is releasing, you feel comfortable, remain in Sphinx pose. And the option is you wanted to go a little deeper, we move into seal pose. So in seal, you just take your hands to the outer edge, elbows face back, lift up. Let the upper body sink down, so a little deeper into the front of the pelvis. Underestimating that moment of rest, that sigh in between poses, which is a sign that we successfully released tension from our spine. Next, let's just slide the hands under the shoulders, tuck the toes underneath, transition slowly into tabletop. Let's take the toes together, knees apart, and just come in a nice little counter pose of child's. Allowing the buttocks to move towards the heels gently. And coming all the way down, maybe stacking your hands. Relaxing, just feeling that nice bit of traction in that lower spine. Close your eyes. exhale, option always, you can bend up this leg, and maybe just starting with that, relax that foot. Take the right hand on the outside, the left hand on the inside, and then just coming to that place where you begin to feel your edge. That little sweet spot, not having to push forward, not having to grab onto the feet and pull the head down. Just let things open on their own. In this practice, time is a physiological, magical component here. Time held in these poses will go a long way in releasing tension from our joints and opening and lengthening our muscles. So just allow yourself to naturally sink, to naturally be here. As we meet each moment as it meets us. No fuss, no drama. Breath at a time. So just sink, let go, be one with this pose. Breathe in and toes. Just allow things to open up naturally on their own. Just feel what you feel, this pose. Just send your awareness and breath into that place. And see if you can just let go a little more. This practice of Yin, we come into this place of stillness and present the moment. Just letting go of things that get stuck in our brains. Last few breaths here. Watch. times we'll slowly release the pose. Coming into our final posture of Shavasana. And just allow yourself to come all the way onto your backs. Arms up, maybe knees in, feet out. Releasing that spine. Let's give ourselves a little hug before we move quite into Shavasana. Catching hold of right leg with right thigh, left leg with left thigh. Letting the body just gently roll side to side here. And when you feel comfortable, you can take the knees, stretch away.